All right, I have 20 books to read in 31 days. It's happening. I'm making sure of that. Hi friends, my name is Jess and welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking through my December TBR. Now, the past couple of months I have been at an intensive work training. I'm starting a new job in December, but I do think that with my new job I will have more time for reading than I did before. So there's like good news and bad news in that statement. The bad news is that I haven't been reading for like the past 2 months, so I'm a little bit behind on my Goodreads goal. I think currently 11 books behind, which is really scary. I know numbers aren't everything and I've still read a lot this year, but I really want to hit my goal of 100 books for the year because I've read over 100 books for like the last 3 or 4 years, and so it's gonna be really sad to me if I don't hit that goal. I just am that way. That's just the way I am, and goals and achievements like that make me happy, so I'm really gonna try my hardest to read the 20 books that I need to this month in order to hit that Goodreads goal. And I have read this many books in a month before, so I know that it's possible for me, and I'm gonna try my hardest to make it a reality. If I cheat and use some shorter books and graphic novels at the end of the month, I'm not even gonna say that's cheating because it's not, it's still reading. So, but I do have 20 like books that I really, really like to read in an ideal world on this list. So let's just hop right into it and go through what those 20 books are that I hope to read in December. So first off, I have a problem with starting books and not finishing them. I think if I didn't have that problem, I wouldn't be 11 books behind even at this point with not reading the last couple of months. But I do have that problem, and the first step to recovery is admittance and acceptance. And so that is what I'm doing here in this video. But I would like to knock some of these off of here. Some of them I just need to like clear off and like start over because I've been on there forever. But there are two that are on this list that I'm in the middle of that I'm just going to continue. And the first of those is The Final Girl Support Group by Grady Hendrix. This is a horror novel following this group of final girls, i.e. women that have survived some kind of massacre, mass killing, horror movie-esque thing. And they all meet in this therapy group like once a month or I think or something. But then they start getting like picked off one by one. Somebody is targeting them, somebody wants them gone. And our main character, she's kind of an unreliable narrator. You're not really sure if she is completely in touch with reality and actually knows what's going on, but we're following her and she is really determined to get to the bottom of who exactly is targeting them, who is after them. So she's trying to figure that out. I am on page 195 of 339, so I only have about 140 pages left of this book, so that should be easy enough to knock out in like 2 hours. I would love to do it today, honestly, but I don't know if I will or not. Review of this book so far is that it's honestly pretty boring, so I'm not loving it, and that's why it's taken me a while to get through it, I think. But hopefully the last 140 pages will knock me out of the water and I will end up really enjoying this. But as of where it stands right now, it's like a 2-3 star book. And then the other book on my currently reading list that I definitely want to finish is The Push by Ashley Audrain. This is a thriller about a young mother who is very much convinced that there is something wrong with her child. She does not form a connection to her baby. She does not like her. She honestly believes that she might be evil. And again, this is a situation of an unreliable narrator where we're not totally sure if our narrator just has something going on where she's out of touch with reality, or if her child is in fact actually evil. This is a really interesting book so far. I just kind of put it down because I was reading it on vacation and then I just didn't pick it up when I got home. I don't know. I was having issues reading this year, as you probably can tell. But from what I've read so far, I really liked it. And I think I stopped right before like a really huge thing happens. So hoping to jump back into this one and finish it up. I think I'll really like this one. So I've been sitting here for the last couple of minutes trying to figure out like what order to reveal my TBR in, because I was trying to think of like a way that I can make it not obvious what videos I'm doing this month, but I feel like that's too much work and there's really no way to make it not obvious. So I'm just gonna go through my list in the order of how it's written. There's like kind of a rhyme or reason, but it's also a little bit mixed up, so let's just jump into it. Another book I hope to get to in December is Horror Store by Grady Hendrix. This is a really cool book. It is a horror novel set in an IKEA store, and it is formatted like an IKEA catalog. It has all kinds of like weird stuff in it, but then it also has like furniture listings, and it's supposed to be like a Swedish or Nordic furniture store. It's supposed to be IKEA, but it's really cool. This is a really unique book and I've heard nothing but good things, so I am hoping I will really enjoy it, and I also hope that it's a quick read to help me meet my reading goal. All right, and then the next two books are for a video I'm finishing up. I don't think anyone will guess what this video is because it's very niche and I'm just doing it because I think it'll be fun. And I don't know if anyone will watch it, but I wanted to do it, so. So for that, I'm going to be reading If We Were Us by K.L. Walther. Sorry, I can't say that. This book is basically, I think it's set in like an exclusive private school, and it's following these four teenagers. It's a YA story, and I think it's like a love square kind of deal. Like, I think somebody is siblings, and then somebody is like the it couple kind of, but the boy character in the it couple is actually in love with the girl's brother. Some kind of weird love square is going on, but it sounds like amazing YA contemporary queer realness, so I'm here for it, and I'm excited to read this one. I think it's going to be a fun time. And then I also am, for that video, reading A Lesson in Vengeance by Victoria Lee. This sounds like a really cool, right up my alley book. It's about like lesbian witches at a dark academia school setting, so I think that sounds amazing. I believe this one is YA as well. It's some kind of mystery where I think our main character went to the school the year before, and her girlfriend died. And I don't know if she died in some kind of like witchy ritual or something, but her death is kind of attributed to her girlfriend, and then she comes back for her senior year, and she's kind of an outcast. Nobody really likes her. There's all this like lore and story behind her. And then she meets this new girl, and I don't know. I think she's trying to stay away from witchcraft, but she gets lured back into it. So I think this sounds really cool. I've heard nothing but good things, and definitely excited to get it read this month. And then I'm planning to read Harlem Shuffle by Colson Whitehead. I'm not totally sure what this book is about. I just read the summary, but I think it's following this man who is a furniture salesman, and he's trying to do right by his family, but then he kind of gets mixed up in the underground world of crime, and he kind of becomes almost like a crime boss, and he's like pawning jewelry and like gets all this clientele of these like shady people. I'm not really exactly sure what the plot of it is other than that, but planning to read that one this month. The next book on my list is The Last Thing He Told Me by Laura Dave. This is a thriller novel following this woman whose husband disappears, and he leaves like one note to her when he leaves that says just protect her, and it's referring to his 16-year-old daughter, and our main character is her stepmom. They don't have the best relationship, but they realize that they kind of have to band together in order to figure out where Owen, her husband, went. So they set off to try and figure out where he went and also like who he is and why he disappeared. So this one sounds really good, and I'm honestly kind of surprised that it ended up in the Goodreads Choice Awards because I haven't heard a lot of buzz about it, but I'm excited for it. I think it sounds good. And obviously because I got it from Book of the Month, I wanted to read it. So it's getting read this month. Next book on my list is Billy Summers by Stephen King. I kind of thought I would never read a Stephen King book again, but I love my Goodreads videos and I just have to do it. So this one actually sounds kind of good. I'm not opposed to reading it, but it's about this man who is a hitman for a living, but he'll only like accept the job if the guy that he's set out to kill is actually really bad. But then he really wants out of the business, so he's doing like one last kill. Then like things get messy, I think. So this one actually sounds kind of good. I'm willing to give it a try. Maybe I'll like it a lot. I don't know. It's kind of a chunk to read in December when I have so many freaking books I have to read, but fingers crossed it'll go well. Probably not surprising, but I'm also planning to read The Wife Upstairs by Rachel Hawkins. This book is a thriller, but it's also a Jane Eyre retelling, which I think is super interesting. It's about this woman who is kind of like a dog walker for the rich, but then I think she meets this man who she's really intrigued by, and he asks her to be some kind of like caretaker for his house or something, and weird stuff's going on. Like, if you know the story of Jane Eyre, I'm assuming that's probably it's going to go in a similar direction, so I think that's super interesting. And I've heard mixed things about this one, but I think it'll be good enough to give a try for sure. Next on the list is Apples Never Fall by Leanne Moriarty, and I actually started this book this morning on audio because I got it from Libro FM through their ALC program. Thank you so much, Libro FM. But there's just something about Leanne Moriarty's writing that just sucks you in. Like, I just already feel so connected to the characters, and I'm just so pumped to read this book. I just think it's gonna be so good just because Leanne Moriarty just like has a way of writing that just, she just creates such a immersive story. I love it. So I'm super excited for this one. And it's basically about these four siblings whose mother goes missing, and they don't want to report it because they don't want it to their father to look guilty. They're also worried about them looking guilty. They're trying to figure out like what actually happened to her though, like if she ran away, if something bad happened to her. They kind of think she just kind of up and left, I believe, but they don't know for sure. And as things start to come to light, it comes out that their parents took in this woman who was like bleeding and knocked on their door in the middle of the night, and then when their mom disappears, this lady is also nowhere to be found. Their father seems to have something to hide, although two of the children think he's innocent and two think he's guilty or could be guilty. So it's a really interesting dynamic. Family drama, suburban drama, missing lady. Sounds great. Sign me up. I'm really excited for this book. Next book on the list is A Rock, Paper, Scissors by Alice Feeney. This is a book following this couple who are kind of on the outs, but with one last chance to save their marriage, they win this trip to Scotland, and so they decide to take it and try to work things out, rekindle their marriage. But it turns out that they didn't win this trip by chance, and someone is actually out to get them, I believe. Just from this cover, I'm super excited. I love a snowy, isolated setting thriller. Like, that is my particular niche of thrillers that I absolutely go crazy over. So I'm so excited to read this one. Heard mixed things, but I think it'll be a fun time, so I'm ready. Next on the list is Arsenic and Adobo by Mia P. Manasala. I'm kind of on the fence about this book because I believe it's a cozy mystery, and I'm not really a cozy mystery kind of person, but I mean, it sounds cute, so I don't know. Maybe it'll knock my socks off and I'll really like it. But basically, it follows this woman who owns this restaurant, and when a food critic and also somebody she used to date ends up dropping dead after a confrontation with her, she's kind of the only suspect. They think maybe she poisoned him or something. So she's trying to figure out what actually happened so she can clear her name. And she has this adorable wiener dog. Hi, my dog just came here. Do you want to say hi? Hi, what are you doing? What's up? Ow. I'm busy. I'm gonna sit up here. Okay. Hey, sit down. So, cute, cozy mystery. It might be fun for, like, the holiday season. I'm ready. Oh my god, the back is so cute. Look at the little dog. I hope he's not... I guess that's the arsenic. She better get him. Next on the list is Razorblade Tears by S.A. Crosby, which I am even more excited to read now because my friend Brennan just told me it was her favorite book of the year. So, hyped for that. This book basically follows these two men who find out that their gay sons were murdered. Now, they weren't necessarily the most accepting and understanding fathers to their sons. Now, at this point, they really just want to avenge their deaths. And along the way, I think that they form a relationship with one another and kind of realize and come to appreciate who their sons were as people. I was originally kind of wary of this book because I felt like it might make me mad, but I think it sounds good and I've heard nothing but good things. So I'm honestly really excited for this and I'm glad it's in the Goodreads Choice Awards. So pushing me to read it sooner than I might have otherwise. And I hope that I love it. The next book I'm planning to read in December is Firefly Lane by Kristen Hannah. This is a story following these two girls who become friends in the eighth grade and become inseparable. I think the book spans across three decades of their lives and what this friendship like means in their lives and how they grow together and apart and things like that. I don't really know exactly if that is the full plot, but that's the gist I got from the summary. So I am a sucker for books about female friendship, and The Nightingale by Kristen Hannah was my personal favorite book that I've read so far this year, so I definitely want to read more of her works. So I think I'm going to start here. Sounds amazing, comes highly recommended, so super excited to pick this one up this month as well. The next book I'm planning to read is Silent by Sarah Alva. This is a story about this young boy who ends up in a foster care group home. He is really having a hard go at life, but he makes this connection with this other boy in the home who is actually mute, so he finds a like safe place to share secrets with to him, and they form like a deeper connection and bond. I think maybe a romance. This is like an indie gay romance, I believe, if I'm not wrong, but also comes very highly recommended. Super excited to read this one. It sounds to me like something I will love, so I'm not worried about this one in terms of my personal enjoyment reading it. It sounds like it might rip me to pieces though, so hopefully I'll be ready for that. Continuing with the gay romance trend, somebody told me that Boyfriend Material by Alexis Hall was their favorite book that they read in 2021, and I said, say less. I will read it. I've had this book for a while, and I don't know why I haven't read it yet, probably because I just have like some kind of issue with reading books when I buy them, but this is basically a fake dating thing. Like, I believe this boy is the son of a rock star and he's trying to clean up his image, so he hires this fake guy to pretend to be his boyfriend to kind of like up his image. But you know, I hope this gives me red, white, and royal blue vibes. I think that is what it's supposed to do, so I'm here for that. That sounds like a great way to end out my year with a bang, so I am going to read this one. I am also planning to read In My Dreams I Hold a Knife by Emily Winstead, I believe is her name. I think this has some dark academia vibes to it, so It says it follows six friends during a college reunion, and there is some kind of unsolved murder. So the reunion turns dark and deadly as they all kind of like uncover secrets that they've been hiding from each other. And there's someone out there who is determined to figure out who the killer was. So the friends are like forced to confront each other and be honest about what actually happened. So this sounds really freaking good. I'm so excited to read this one. I know that Caroline loved this one, and I think some of my other friends that have read it have loved it. So I'm ready for it. This one sounds right up my alley. I love a thriller and I love a dark academia setting, so this will be a good one. This will be a good one. Then I would also like to read Be Still My Heart by Emily McIntyre and Sav Miller. I think this is a romance book, but it's also a mystery, so I think that sounds pretty cool. It's also set in Maine, in like a New England fishing town, so that's a kind of setting I love and I'm a sucker for, so I think I might actually really like this book. I think it's a grumpy sunshine kind of deal, and our female love interest is a detective trying to solve this case in this town, and our male love interest is an ex-SEAL who is grumpily having to assist her, and I think he runs some kind of lobster fishing business. But I think that they have like a little romance and they're solving the mystery. It actually sounds really cute, and I know Amanda loved it, so I trust her. I am gonna try to read this one as well. And then finally, I decided to pick out for my final two books that I just am like so excited to read that have been on my shelf and I don't know why I haven't read them yet this year. So the first of those is White Smoke by Tiffany D. Jackson. This is a signed first edition, as you can see, that I actually got when I was up with Amanda for the weekend. Fun stuff. So in this book, our main character moves to a new house in a new town, and weird things start to happen in that house, and she comes to the conclusion that it is likely haunted. So she's a little bit freaked out, and it's not just the house, it actually is like the whole town that they're living in that has some really dark secrets. Things start getting crazy. I don't want to know too much more than that because I don't want to give it away, but this sounds so good, and Tiffany D. Jackson is such a talented writer. I loved Grown by her that I read this year, so I'm super excited to pick up more of her work, and this sounds right up my alley. Love me a creepy, ghosty, haunted house horror book, so I think this is gonna be excellent. And last but not least, I really, really, really want to read Under the Whispering Door by TJ Klune before the end of the year. This is the beautiful exclusive edition. I'm not a big like special edition book person, but I like could not resist these. I also got The House in the Cerulean Sea in this copy. It's just so beautiful, like the font's different. It's so lovely, and look at this freaking spine. Oh my god, I love it. I love it so much. It's so pretty. I can't. It's so pretty. I love it. And like them together. Excuse me. I love it so much. They're so pretty. Okay. Anyway, I loved The House in the Cerulean Sea last year. That ended up being one of my favorite books of the year. So this one sounds equally as cute and amazing. I think this one is about this man named Wallace, who has passed away, and the Reaper comes to collect him, but he's very hesitant to cross over, and I think he doesn't believe that he's actually dead, and he's really freaked out by the whole thing. But then he meets this man named Hugo, who owns this little tea shop and promises to help him cross over, and I think he starts to fall for him. I think this is gonna be really cute and just right up my alley, and so excited. I think it is set in the same world as The House in the Cerulean Sea, so I think that will be interesting. I don't know if there will be any like characters featured or anything, but either way, I'm super excited for this one. I'm dying to read it, so I have to read it before the end of the year. All right, and those are the 20 books that I'm planning to read in December. This is definitely overambitious, but I'm gonna make it happen some way, somehow. I would love to film a 24-hour reading vlog this month, but I don't know that I'm gonna be able to do that, so hopefully I'll just be able to vlog things here and there, and that I will still make it through this stack of books. I'm gonna do my best, but yes, please let me know what you're planning to read in December. I would love to know, and yeah. But that's going to be it for me today. I hope you guys have a great last month of the year, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.